A lot of people talk about invest into this, invest into that, buy this, buy that, but they never tell you what to stay away from.
Put my chick inside some Louis and some Valentino. Put my bro inside some Gucci and some new machino. They want my money like it's a casino.
Alright, what's good guys? It's Pokey Banks, baby. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, please leave a like, comment and subscribe. Let's get it.
By the way, guys, if you want to win a free share worth between £3 and £200, make sure you click the link in my description or swipe up and then you deposit £1. Let me know what share you get. It's Pokey Banks, baby.
Now, today's video, we're going to be talking about 6 things that you should not be investing into and what I don't invest into. I'm going to go over every single one and explain why I don't invest into them and why they're bad investments. Because I realized a lot of people want to tell you what to invest into, but I feel like I should tell you guys what you should stay away from. Because, guys, the easy way for you to not lose money is simply to tell you what to stay away from. And if you stay away from it, you automatically not lose money. Simple as. So let's get it with the first one, and that is savings accounts. I do not invest into savings account. Allow me to explain. Now, in today's economy, savings accounts are one of the most unwise investments that you can make if you're looking to make a gain or return on your money. So today's day is 16th of April, 2021. The Bank of England's base rate is currently 0.1%, which dropped from 0.25% in March 2020 from the coronavirus shock. So this also means that high street banks won't be offering much either, something closer to 0.5%. This means if you were to invest £1,000 into a savings account, with a 0.5% interest rate, you'll get £5 on top, so you'll be left with £1,005. And guess what makes this even worse? The silent killer, inflation. This means it'll cost you way more money to buy your everyday goods than it would have cost you a year ago. For example, you may see a gradual rise in oil prices, house prices, grocery shopping, all sorts. Now, as you can see on the screen right here, these are the average saving rates from 2019 to 2020. As you can see, they aren't that great. Inflation in 2019 was 1.8% and then inflation in 2020 was 0.9%. Now, if you put your money into an Easy Access Savings account in the 1st of December 2019, you have seen a loss of real value of 0.3% in your money. The calculation I used to get that figure is by using the interest rate, which is 0.6%, minus inflation, so that's taken away, is devaluing the pound or the dollar. This will give you minus 0.3%, and that'll be your real rate of return on your investment. But guys, don't get me wrong, in your savings account, you will not lose money. Your money still will go up as face value. But the problem is that prices everywhere else are increasing at a faster rate. So like I said, oil prices, housing prices. So in reality, you have to spend more than what you usually would have spent like a year ago to buy the common goods that you normally get every single year. And for that reason, this is why savings accounts aren't a good investment for me. Now guys, look, if you're looking to buy something within the next, you know, 3 months, then of course, put your money in the savings account. But just remember, you're not putting your money in there to gain an interest because the interest is nil anyway. But what you put your money into is to save your money, keep it in a safe place. If I was looking to save something or buy something within the next 1 to 2 years, then I'd probably put into an index fund like the S&P 500, personally. That's what I would do. Furthermore, guys, my name is Pokey Banks. It's only right I play the same game that the banks play. Because when you put your money in your savings account, they use this money to go invest and put into mortgages or credit card products, loaning people money at 11%, giving mortgages at 3.5%, doing car loans at 27%. Look, they're making money off your savings. So let's play the same game as the banks. Let's cut out the middleman and just invest ourselves. Number two, the second thing that I don't invest into is hype, hot tips, or a salesman coming to me to promote a stock or a cryptocurrency. Allow me to explain. Now, when a man comes up to you, they may DM you, approach you on the street, cold call you, whatever. If they come to you and propose an investment opportunity, like they claim that they have the next best Tesla or Bitcoin, this is what you need to do. Block them and then run as far as you can. Simple as. Think about it. Why are they helping you? A random person they don't know, they're telling you what the next best investment is. For number one, they can benefit of you investing in the asset or the opportunity. Why? With the increase in prices, as it may be determined by supply and demand. They could also be referring you to a platform where they have an affiliate link, so they make money off you signing up. They don't care whether you lose money or make money. Wait, wait, guys, don't get me wrong. Your close friend, your family member, or a business partner can give you a hot tip, or they could give you a recommendation to invest into a certain stock or cryptocurrency with good intentions. Don't get me wrong, I'm not disputing that. But if someone with a non-existent track record and a random person will just come up to you randomly saying, buy this, buy that, oh, you should invest into this, don't invest into that, invest into this, but look at it with two eyes. So this means not taking no stock recommendations of anyone on TikTok or anything. Remember guys, there's no barrier to entry in this game. Anyone can pick up a phone and start saying they're a stock expert. They can become a guru overnight. So just because someone has 500k followers, 100k followers, a million followers, does not mean everything they say is concrete facts. But guys, what my job is here is to implant an idea in your brain and be the gatekeeper for you to invest in. So I'm gonna present you with the idea and then you can go away and then search it for yourselves and learn more. Yes, I don't invest into hot tips or savings accounts, but again, I've explained my reasons why. What you now need to do is go away and find out why you don't wanna do that. Don't be a sheep and don't do it because I've said so. Unless you agree with my opinions and you understand, then fair enough. But before I go into why I don't invest in bonds, let's just explain what bonds are. They are fixed income instruments, which are essentially loans given by an investor to a corporate company or a government. So bonds, your principal payment, which is your original sum that you invested, is paid back to you at the end of the term. Where you're making money with the bonds is with the interest rates. So they'll be paying you this over the term. So not at the end of the term where the principal payment is given back to you, but throughout the term, so you get your interest. Now guys, I will say that bonds, they inversely correlate with savings accounts. So when savings account interest rates are pretty low, bond rates normally go a lot higher. But as you can see with this example here, but don't forget, these bond rates are fixed. So for example, with a 5-year bond rate, you will not be able to take your money out for 5 years. It's locked away. Now the reason why a lot of people go with bonds is that it's a safe, predictable way for you to get a guaranteed return on your money. It's very predictable, so those that are not looking to take too much risk and they just want guaranteed money, this is the best way for you to go forward. So this also means people over the age of 50, closer to retirement, have a big sum of money, but they don't want to risk it into the stock market or crypto market or anything too risky. They'll put into bonds. Why? Because they've got a guaranteed rate. And they also want to make sure they can guarantee their retirement in the right investment, for example, a bond. These investments will then also help to preserve their capital. But guys, look at me. I'm 20 years old. I'm nowhere near 50. I'm nowhere near my retirement stage. What the hell am I doing with bonds? Look guys, I'm young and I'm just telling you guys now, you can go broke 3-4 times in your 20s and still be rich by the time you're 30. I've got investments in businesses, I trade forex, I've got investments in crypto, even some altcoins, very, very low market cap coins. So essentially, it makes no sense for me to put my money into bonds and play way too safe. You gotta live life, you gotta take risks and prosper. And again, you know, bonds are a little bit too boring for me right now. I can deal with that when I'm 60. So judging by what I said, you can then now gauge whether bonds are for you or not. 50% of my audience is 18 to 24, so I would guess otherwise. The fourth thing that I don't invest my money into is simply pyramid schemes. Now, none of you guys should be investing into this. This is just simply an unsustainable business model that requires you to recruit more members to recover your joining fee. And you do this by selling overrated goods and services, which pretty much aren't worth it most of the time, or there's better alternatives on the market. And then build a team below you to then do this for you. And then you get a percentage of all of their sales. So basically, the ones at the top, they eat the most, whereas the ones at the bottom, they're left with the crumbs. And again, the reason why I don't invest in any of these or join any of these is because firstly, most of the people at the bottom, they don't make money. So why would I want to promote something to my loyal fan base and help them lose money? I only want to promote things that will help everyone grow together. For example, my course and stuff at Elevation.co.uk, risk-free betting. If you're over the ages of 18 and you want to make some guaranteed money risk-free betting, make sure to click the link below and go to my course, selfelevation.co.uk. Now, here's how you spot a pyramid scheme. One sign that this is a pyramid scheme is that there's a large initial investment or there's an upfront joining fee. The second sign is that you're selling products that are very overrated and that provide little to no value. There's better alternatives in the market. The third sign that the people recruiting you are pushing the agenda that you need to recruit loads more members and get more people to sign up for you to make money. And the fourth sign that is a pyramid scheme is that you are now pushed to recruit people to become your franchisees or sub-distributors to sell your bad goods and services. Now the fifth thing that I don't invest my money into is stocks. Now this one's more of a personal thing for me, hear me out. Now guys, don't get me wrong, there's nothing wrong with, you know, investing in individual stocks. And trust me, you can make a lot of money then. If you invest into Tesla, Amazon or Netflix at the right time, you'd have seen a lot of money. But one thing I want to say is that I believe in focus. Right now, I'm currently trading forex, investing into cryptocurrency and dollar cost averaging into index funds like the S&P 500 and the FTSE World Index. I'll be real with you guys, right now in my life, how I'm doing things, you know, with uni and sorting out my personal brand, I just don't have the time to learn stocks, individual stock picking to a high degree. Right now, as I speak on the 16th of April, 2021, I believe there's an abundance of opportunities in the crypto market where you can make, you know, 100%, 200%. Even today, some of my cryptos have gone up 300%. That's quadruple. Furthermore, another general point why I don't pick stocks, you know, individual stocks, is that you can, you know, read all of the reports, study all of the news, understand all of the fundamentals and still underperform the market, which is the S&P 500. SP Dow Jones Indices released a report in 2019 that shows that hedge funds have been finding it increasingly hard to compete with the S&P 500, where after 9 years, 64% of hedge funds underperform the market. After 10 years, 85% of hedge funds underperform the market. And after 15 years, it's 91% underperform the market. So the thing is, right, you can have a good year, a good 2 years in the stock market, but guys, can you continuously do this for the next 30 years? And that's why I'd rather put my money into the S&P 500. Now, who knows, things can change in the future, but right now, that's not where I'm focusing my energy on. And now, the final and sixth thing that you should not be investing your money into is simply things you don't understand. Don't overdo it. This one should be relatively easy to understand. Don't invest your money into a platform that you've read no reviews on. Don't invest your money into an industry that you know nothing about. Don't buy a stock or crypto based off hype without doing your research. I understand stocks to a basic level, but I will not say that I'm an expert when it comes to picking stocks. Therefore, I don't pick stocks. Simple as. Find something that you understand and like, and then take your knowledge to a proficient level where you can now make a lot of moves within that industry. Trust me, you'll make a lot more money when you're smart at one specific thing, when everyone knows you for that one thing very, very good. But yeah, guys, that's the video for today. If there's any other investors that you don't invest into or there's anybody you disagree with, let me know down below. You already know. It's PokeyDX, babe.